I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, 'cause I always wanted me one that was long and black. One day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in a lunchbox in my hand. Now getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, 'cause I'll have the only one there is around. So the very next day when I punched in with my big lunchbox and with help from my friend, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gear. I've never considered myself a thief, but GM wouldn't miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. The first day I got me a fuel pump, and the next day I got me an engine and a trunk. Then I got...
This is the donor car that I've stolen some parts out of today. The Catalina, I think is what these were. Probably wrong. Kind of hard to recognize. It is a Chevy. Mafia staff car, perhaps. Got the same motor in her. I stole the radiator and the battery cables. I'll be back for that alternator when I get a chance. Might take this mirror. It's kind of cool. It's a bit loose though. Or not. Moving on.
The first day I got me a fuel pump, and the next day I got me an engine and a trunk. Then I got me a transmission and all the chrome.
Damn it. I just hauled one of these to the scrapyard. I couldn't get a motor. And look at that. Triumph TR7 sitting here. With a motor sitting in it. Ah, damn it. That's just the way things go. Here's the back of the cab. Right there. In case you need to replace any body panels someday. Pretty complete car. However, it is still a TR7. Incredibly difficult vehicle to work on. That's probably good enough for today. Finish up.
The little things I could get in my big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shocks, but the big stuff we snuck out my buddy's mobile.
Well, we're running out of daylight. We're not ready to start yet. But I was going to get him spinning over today. You guys like my, my battery basket. I think it's kind of cool. Functions, does the job, holds the battery, and it's plenty strong. Made that today. Oh. That battery is one that I had laying around. I do not know if it's any good, but she is taking a charge, so. And it's very small, so I won't be running that one. Everything's all together, of course. There's the radiator mocked up in the truck where he's gonna go. tomorrow, in theory, it'll crank over. I don't know if it will right now. I don't know if I've got enough of a charge in him. We can try it, though. It should be absolutely terrifying. Let's give her a shot. Not enough charge. Dang it. And we tripped the battery charger. Of course we did. Oh, it's so much fun. Well, that's what we've been up to. Y'all have fun.